FN Radio. It's all about what's next. Go to financialsurvivalnetwork.com and sign up for your free weekly newsletter. You'll also get 3 free reports. The Financial Survival Network. It's all about what's next.
Welcome. You are listening to the Financial Survival Network. It's Kerry Lutz, and you know how unstable the financial system is. Anything could just set it reeling at any moment, and there are certain things going on right now that are extremely worrisome, but the question is, what is going to happen next? Well, Bix Weir written an interesting article about what's really going on. Bix, hey, it's been a while. Welcome back.
Thank you, Kerry. It's nice to be on again.
As always. So what's going on here with the Glencore and all the commodity rigging, and why does it pose such a threat to the world financial system?
Well, the key to understanding all this mess that's been going on in gold and silver for the past, since 1971, since we went off the gold standard, is understanding that in an unbacked system, the biggest threat to that system is the rise in commodity prices, because the rise in commodity prices is what is the telltale sign that your currency is unstable. So it's really not the rise in the price of the commodity. It's the lowering in the value of the unbacked fiat currency that you're using. So what they did in 1971 is set up this thing called the petrodollar. And the petrodollar was a scam, basically, that Kissinger put in place with the Mossad of Israel to rig the oil markets with Saudi Arabia, and they can recycle those dollars. Saudi Arabia will get all the money from the oil, and then they'll reinvest it in the stock market and U.S. treasuries and things like that. And you've got a complete circle. And you can do a lot of that with the derivatives market, the futures, the options, and the LBMA type of stuff on, especially gold and silver and oil. Those are the three biggies. But what you also need to do is you need to control the physical side of the market. This is the tiny, tiny bit of the equation that determines the price of all commodities these days. And in order to do that, Kissinger hired a guy named Mark Rich in the early 70s to basically control the physical side of the game. And so he's was the largest commodity trader in the world. He trained a bunch of guys to do exactly what he does. And what he does is he rigs the market. He'll hold back certain commodities when he wants the price to go up, and he'll flood the market when he wants the price to go down. He also taught his traders to use a lot of derivatives, because you can make more money that way. If you put all your long bets down before you rig the physical supply of the metal, you're going to do very well. So he trained a bunch of guys, and they called them the Rich Boys. And one more thing on Mark Rich. This is the guy that Bill Clinton, of all people, pardoned in January 2001.
It was Denise his last. Rich was a contributor, a major contributor to the Clinton Foundation and all of that. The library.
That was the story. I mean, that is the cover story, is that Clinton and Hillary and Bill got money from donations from this guy. It was the cover story. The reality was he was hired to control the strong dollar policy of Clinton during his presidency. All the strong dollar policy was the rigging of the markets to control the value of the dollar, especially gold and silver. So Mark Rich has been the guy in charge. He trained these guys they call the Rich Boys. And one of the Rich Boys, or two of them, are in charge of the largest physical commodity companies in the world. Glencore is one of them, and the CEO is a guy named Ivan Glasenberg. And, he runs the kind of the physical side of controlling the markets. They have a lot of derivatives that they use, but they also hold back and release metal as needed. Same with oil. And the other guy was Claude Dauphin, and he was with Trafigura, and he mysteriously died on Friday in Colombia, of all places. He was a Swiss national, and they say he was dying of cancer, but for some reason he ended up in Colombia on his deathbed and died. Just crazy, crazy stuff. So all these guys are in on the physical side of the rig, and that's what's falling apart right now, as you could tell with all the the missing physical silver that people can't find these days. Glencore, Trafigura, and the physical side of the manipulation is breaking down. And these guys have been, you know, Mark Rich was indicted on 65 counts of fraud and money embezzling and been trading oil with Iran. Just crazy stuff that anybody else would spend. You know, he theoretically, he should have spent over 300 years in prison. And all these guys are in on it. Glencore, Trafigura, they're all in on it. And that's what's falling apart right now. And they're trying to get out of it. They're having a hard time. Glencore by itself has, they claim they have $30 billion in debt. That there is a Reuters article today saying, well, that's not counting the open lines of credit and all the letters of credit on the commodities. It's more like $100 billion. So this is a huge, huge deal. And they're trying to cover it up. And the banks are trying to keep the stock price of Glencore up. But it's a losing game. And this is the end game. This is the takeout of the physical side of the market. And once that's done, you can kiss everything else goodbye.
Yeah. Well, I guess it's getting closer and closer to the final solution here, huh?
Well, yeah, and the final solution will be the end of the shorting as the price rises. Ted Butler talks about this all the time in silver. He says, you know, there's the commercials and the other side. There's basically two sides of a trade. They play off each other, and one's led by momentum, the trading guys. So guys like, you know, the Glencore group and Trafigura would rig the physical side, and then they'd play the long or short, depending on where they're going to make the most money on the options and derivatives. Well, that has broken down with these low prices of commodities. And the collateral that they use has also gone through the floor. So these banks have loans based on metal collateral and oil collateral, and all that collateral has dropped so far below the kind of the minimum threshold of what the banks are supposed to be holding, that now that the word is, if Glencore gets downgraded, right now it's still investment grade, I think it's BBB. If they get downgraded, there's all these collateral calls that happen, and they don't have the collateral. They don't have the money, and they don't have the metal to back it up. So at least the value of that metal. Yeah, if the commodity prices double all of a sudden, they might have it. But it doesn't look like they are, because there's somebody else. There's somebody else keeping the price down. I think, you know, I call them the good guys that control the market. But, you know, we'll see if they can break the back of these physical companies, physical commodity companies. Then we will finally see the breakout of gold and silver, which would be wonderful. Although all the banks will lose, and you'll have your gigantic implosion that everybody's been talking about.
Yeah, well, or will they be able to stave it off one last time?
I don't think they want it. I mean, I always talk about the good guys and the bad guys have similar agendas but different. The good guys want to crash the system to get rid of these bad bankers and go back to a more fair system. The bad guys want to crash the system because they know they're in trouble, and all their past deeds of rigging markets and bribing congressmen and all that, they want to wash that away with some kind of market collapse, so that you can't really know who did what in the past. And you remember, like, a while back, the Hurricane Sandy.
Yeah, sure.
And it flooded the basement of the DTCC.
Yeah,
where,
how convenient.
$35 trillion worth of paper assets. So that was just a gigantic operation to destroy the physical evidence. And they did it. They flooded that vault at 55 Water Street for 1 month. And then after they drained it, they set it on fire. Just crazy stuff like that. That's what they're trying to get rid of. And now it's gotten so bad that the bad guys want to crash the system as well. So we're at that end point. And the trigger, if anybody's looking for a real trigger, it's this situation with Glencore, Trafigura, and all the commodity companies that basically are physical on the physical side, but also are knee deep in the metal derivatives.
Yeah. Well, it's going to get interesting real quick, isn't it?
I think it already is interesting. I mean, we're in the middle of this game. Glencore's stock dropped in one day, like, what was it, 29%, something ridiculous. And then all the shareholders jump in and the banks start buying the stock just so it doesn't send the whole system down. But this is the game. This, we had a 1,000-point drop in a in the Dow intraday over 1,000 points. So the shaking is happening right now. And, you know, when will it end? I don't know if it will ever end. You know, some people will never say, oh, this is over. It's done. We won. I see more of a ceasing of the system before that happens. And the ceasing of the system will be caused by the bank derivatives. The Deutsche Bank, I think it's 75 or 80 trillion in derivatives. Yeah. A lot of talk about Deutsche Bank being in deep, deep, deep problems these days. One, because of all the derivatives on European sovereign debt, but also mm-hmm. Deutsche Bank is knee deep with these guys at Glencore and Trafigura on the commodity derivative side. So we'll see. You know, everything seems to be shaking and happening, but it's mm-hmm. it's kind of like just hold on and wait again.
Yeah, hurry up and wait, huh?
That's the idea these days. And but compared to a year ago when, you know, the everybody was saying, oh yeah, the system, we've recovered and we're into the next boom, you know, not many people saying that right now.
Hey, what happened to recovery summer anyway?
What happened to the green shoots? Remember those
green shoots? Yeah, where did those green shoots go? They don't look too green anymore, do they, Bix?
No, they were spray painted green and now
the paint has worn off.
The rain is coming in. It's washing away all the spray paint.
Yeah, the emperor has no clothes. It's just
that's true.
Yeah, but how do people fall for this crap is what I'd like to know.
The media. I mean, obviously nobody in our camp falls for it. There's just so much information out there now. And even the mainstream stock market analysts and things like that, even those guys are saying, you know, we're in a gigantic bubble. You look at Zero Hedge every day. There's 10 analysts saying, oh my God, I've predicted this bubble for 70 years. All you got to do is predict when they're going to turn off the computer programs or when they're going to, you know, force the computer programs to crash the system and return us to something sound. That's the key. When these rigging programs go off, which I've shown many times, I mean, the very name Road to Ruta, Ruta is R-O-O-T-A, meaning root A in the computer program language of BASIC that was invented by, you know, John Kennedy back in the 60s and Alan Greenspan. He basically invented the financial system using root A. So all this stuff comes down to computers and derivatives. When are they going to shut it off or when are they going to turn it on itself? And that's how you get rid of these bad guys. And that's how you get rid of the system.
Well, I love the concept of it. And it's just it's happening so quick. And it appears that it was happening slowly, but the pace is picking up. And Glencore could just tip it over the edge. And hey, maybe the road to Ruta is here. Who knows? But Bix.
The end of the road to Ruta.
Hey, so tell us how we find out more about you. Subscribe to your site and get all your publications, your books, et cetera.
You can go to roadtoruta.com. There's a free side that I send out emails every couple days about, you know, I like to stick to the inside stuff like, you know, Glencore and Trafigura and Mark Rich and the conspiracy at the U.S. Mint or the big monster conspiracy of the gold in the Grand Canyon. That I've been diving into that one and have some, you know, insiders coming out of the woodwork saying, hey, I tried to get back to there. I've been there. I've seen it and things like that. So it's really fun these days as far as, unless you watch like the mainstream media or listen to the mainstream gold and silver people who say, you know, oh yes, we're in a bear market. That's ridiculous. It's all rigged on the computer. So yeah, come by and visit and check out the fun stuff that we're dealing with over here.
All right. And as always, you will find a link to Bix's work in the show notes to this interview on financialsurvivalnetwork.com. And while you're there, take a look. We've got so many articles dealing with what Bix is talking about because, look, the mainstream media, everything's fine and dandy, but it's, as George Carlin would say, Bix, it's neither fine nor dandy, and there's a lot of problems that you need to know about and be prepared for. Anyway, Bix, we'll talk with you again soon. Keep up the great work. Be well.
All right, Carrie, take it easy.
FSN Radio. It's all about what's next. Go to financialsurvivalnetwork.com and sign up for your free weekly newsletter. You'll also get 3 free reports. The Financial Survival Network. It's all about what's next.